Welcome to the ThinkCell Tutorials. This video provides step-by-step instructions on how to build a waterfall chart with ThinkCell. A waterfall chart visualizes how a starting value is increased or decreased by intermediate positive or negative values to result in a final value. To insert a waterfall chart, go to the ThinkCell group in the PowerPoint ribbon, open the Elements menu, and click on either Build Up Waterfall or Build Down Waterfall. Let's start with a Build Up Waterfall. Click once onto the slide to place the chart there. A default Build Up Waterfall chart is inserted. In this chart type, the segments of each category build up from left to right to result in a total column on the very right of the chart. Open the data sheet to type your starting value in column B, and add positive or negative values in the subsequent columns. Positive values result in segments going upwards. Negative values create segments going downwards. After you have entered the values for all segments of your build-up waterfall, type in an E for equals into the column furthest to the right of the datasheet. ThinkCell automatically calculates the total of the values to the left of this column and keeps it up to date whenever you change the data. You don't have to calculate the sums yourself. Now let's insert a Build Down Waterfall from the Elements menu. It works similarly to the Build Up Waterfall you've just seen, with one basic difference. The data sheet will have an E in the first column and thus show the total on the very left of the chart. In a Build Down Waterfall chart, ThinkCell starts from the column furthest to the right of the data sheet and calculates backwards from right to left to find the value for the E column. Or in other words, ThinkCell builds down the total column on the very left of the chart to the individual categories that comprise it. Now you know the differences between a build up and a build down waterfall. You may also type an E into columns of the data sheet other than the first or last. ThinkCell will then calculate subtotals up to that point, building up or building down, depending on which waterfall type you inserted, and a corresponding subtotal column will be displayed in the chart. You can, of course, enter more than one value in each column of the datasheet. You can even have both positive and negative values within the same column. The chart will automatically display a total label on top or at the bottom of all columns with multiple segments. ThinkCell automatically positions connectors between each column, visualizing the sum of the segments of a column. If all segments of a column have the same sign, these connectors are anchored to the top or bottom of a column. If you use both positive and negative values within the same column, its connector may not be at the top or bottom of a column, because it needs to represent the sum of a column and is placed at the corresponding position. In our case, the sum of the second column is plus 2, and therefore the right connector is anchored at the position that lies 2 units above the previous connector. Now that you have entered the data for your waterfall chart, let's look at how to format and style it. You probably want to label your columns. That's easy. Just open the datasheet and type the name for each column into the category row at the top of the datasheet. If you would like to change the color of certain segments, just select them with your mouse and pick your preferred fill color from the floating toolbar. Let's assume that you use an external Excel workbook as the data source for your waterfall chart and that you use conditional formatting on your data. For instance, to show positive values with a green and negative values with a red fill color. In this case, you can adopt the conditional formatting to the fill color of your waterfall segments. Left-click in an empty space on the chart and tick Use Excel Fill on Top from the Fill Color drop-down menu. You may also sort categories of the waterfall chart by their total values directly from the chart's floating toolbar. For instance, to highlight the products with the highest positive contribution to the turnover. Left-click on the chart and open the category sorting control box. Let's say you would like to sort the product categories according to their contribution to the turnover by showing all positive columns first and only then the negative columns, while keeping the starting value of your datasheet in the initial position of the chart. Pick the option Categories First Up, Then Down, Excluding Start from the drop-down menu. The chart changes accordingly, and the categories are sorted starting with the highest positive total on the left to the highest negative total on the right. Explore the other sorting options if needed. Please note that segment labels of negative values do not show a minus by default because the negative value is already represented by the segment going downwards. If you would like to display a minus in these segment labels regardless, just left-click on any of them and change the number format in the control box. All labels of the same type will be changed. You can also change the color and style of the connectors. Select or multi-select the connectors by clicking or shift-clicking on them and pick your preferred color and style from the drop-down menu. Now you know how to build and style a basic waterfall chart with ThinkCell. If you would like to create more complex waterfalls like these examples, please continue watching to see how this is done. The first step to building a complex waterfall chart is to enter your complete data into the datasheet. When you are finished with this, you further configure the chart and its connectors with your mouse. Let's have a closer look at this. You can change the position of any connector in the chart. To do this, first select the connector by clicking on it. The connector shows a handle on each end. When you click and drag the handle you want to move, all available anchor points are highlighted. Drag to your preferred anchor point and release. Repeat this for other handles if necessary. Whenever you reposition a connector, the entire chart rearranges to accommodate the change and all equals columns are updated. Please be aware that if you move a connector, the meaning of your chart may change. In a basic waterfall chart, two columns are connected by one horizontal connector. If you want to dissolve this connection, for instance because you want to use the first column of the chart as a reference value, you can separate it from the other columns of your waterfall chart. Just click on the connector between the first and second column and hit the delete key. The connector is deleted and the first column is now separated from the sum calculation of the waterfall and will remain so when you change the values in the datasheet. You can also add connectors to the waterfall. Right-click into the chart and select Add Waterfall Connector from the context menu. Click once on an anchor point to place one end of the connector. Then click again on another anchor point to place the other end of the connector. Your new connector is now set. Now that you've learned how to change, delete, and add connectors, let's have a look at how this can be used in a concrete example of a complex waterfall chart. Let's say you would like to show two different scenarios within one waterfall chart. Start by entering the values for both scenarios into different categories of the datasheet. Then reconfigure the connectors for the segments of the different scenarios one by one to build a waterfall that is adding up to two separate flows. Now you are done. Your complex two-scenario waterfall chart is complete. That's it for this video. Thanks for watching. Please visit our website for more ThinkCell tutorials.